here in the emergency department, we see basically anyone who presents with emergency issues that ranges from major trauma, heart attacks, all the way down to the severely twisted ankle. So it's a first place for patients to come who are sick, they're ill, they're injured, and we're here to provide service for them. The story of coming to a wheelchair began January 6th, 2012. We're on the third day of a backcountry ski trip with a group of friends and coming down a, you know, reasonably treed slope. Unfortunately, caught my edge on something in the snow and struck a tree. In that moment, things kind of changed a bit as I ended up breaking my neck at C7, which has left me paralyzed from the chest down and some impairment of my hand function. It was a bit of a surreal experience to start. I got a helicopter ride off the mountain, which would have been a lot more fun if it were not for the injury. That was followed by a trip with the Stars Air Ambulance and a crew that I had worked with for almost a decade. A trip through my own emergency department as a patient, which is definitely a different perspective. And that was followed by traversing almost the entirety of the hospital system over the next 6 months as I went from acute care to rehab. About the experience of my care, I'd have to say that, injury aside, it was an amazingly positive experience. The people in this system make the system and are really there to get you better and get you home with everything you can do. My disability insurance certainly played a huge role in getting back to work. In the initial stages of the injury, of course, it allowed us just to go on with life as was normal. It allowed us to be aggressive about rehab therapy, which is of course going to be a core part of coming back to work. And once we even got back to work, not only were we still supported by the disability insurance, we found that we were having some challenges getting around the department. The Foothills Medical Center in particular is a very large emergency department, and by the end of the day, we were noticing I was having significant fatigue in my shoulders and traversing the department. So in speaking with our insurance, we decided that we would go ahead with a unit called a smart drive, which is a battery operated device that attaches both to the wheelchair as well as a little flywheel on the back, and it provides me some extra support and ability to get around the department without suffering that kind of fatigue. I refer to us and we because the benefits that I've had extend to my family. That would include my wife Leanne. It includes your parents, your friends, my brother who lives out of country, because without these sort of disability insurance and supports, they then become your support system. They already are that emotionally, but certainly they become that financially if you're not able to work. I'm still quite actively involved in STARS. I'm now doing mostly education for our air medical crew and the outreach training for our Royal Physicians still. It's just been an amazing experience. It's a great organization, an amazing group of people, and just a lot of fun to be involved with. I've been really lucky. I've worked with the residency program since we've started here in Calgary, and that's a wide variety from our first year trainees who are starting out in a variety of different disciplines, all the way up to our senior emergency medicine residents who are within a few months of passing their exams and becoming fully certified specialists. It's a blessing. These are amazing people. They're dedicated to what they do, and if nothing else, it really keeps you sharp. In order to challenge these learning and cutting edge physicians, you too have to stay on top of things. So it's a really big part of my career, and it's a big part of what kind of drives me forward and keeps me doing good. The disability insurance was huge. As you can imagine, with a spinal cord injury, particularly in hospital, and when you first get out, you just earn no income. That's devastating if you don't have some form of backup. The disability insurance here really paid for your day-to-day living expenses. It allowed you to undertake outpatient rehab. It allowed you to afford wheelchairs and all those other things that are not necessarily covered by any other insurance plan. It allowed us to focus on the rehab and getting better and getting back to work, as opposed to being worried about the financial strains and constraints that you might have without. I would think this is important to have right from the first day of medical school. I think doctors suffer from that vision that we are immune to illness. We work in this system where we take care of people. We're not the ones receiving care. And the message I can get across today is that we're as likely as anyone else to be injured, to be ill, and take a moment just to think about that. This is also a practice and a business. You really need to ensure that you're going to be able to continue to earn income and a lifestyle that allows you to be a clinician and provide those services to your patients. The insurance team for us has been an amazingly supportive group with AMA, with ADM Insurance and Sun Life. The thing I think I was struck most by is how seamless it was and how little effort was involved in getting that disability insurance started, having it reassessed. We were always supported in our decisions of what we were doing, trying to get back to work, and never penalized for any of that. I think if there was a take-home message I would have today is that re-examine your insurance needs and disability needs as your practice changes. It's a really important part of the practice we do, and unfortunately one that we are all too apt to ignore.